it swollen. Ooh, la mama, you so chosen. I can't even take it from you. My baby on fleek, yeah. That pussy so sweet, yeah. Let that shit drip on my teeth, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I need me a freak, yeah. Don't buy nothing cheap, yeah. I keep lil' mama on fleek, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I'm on the Forbes list. Keep lil' mama in Dior drip. Educated and she gorgeous. Sexy mojo, I might blow a kiss. Drop a bag, yeah, she know I'm rich. Ghetto boozy, she ain't born shit. I'm a iced out of arm and wrist. Pink and ring and a charming gliss. Big on big love, ain't normal shit. No.
I was recording now?
Yeah.
Blame it on Monstah here. You're now tuned in to Fresh Talkz.
Man, I have a super dope guest in the building. You know what I'm saying? Super producer. We talking records like, you know, Fleet. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Man, this lit, man. All right, man, I have Blame It on Monstah, man. I appreciate you coming.
Hey, man, appreciate the invite.
Yes, sir. So, man, this take me down, like, where you from, man? I think he's telling me from, like, a town like Goodloe?
Goodloe, Texas. Oh. 903 East Texas. Okay. Yes, sir. Okay. Repping it all day.
Okay, okay. So, man, what was your upbringing like?
Church, school, and church. That's pretty much it. That's it. I played drums. I started playing drums. I was like 5 years old. My aunt told me how to play the drums, and it just went from there. Like, my granny could sing, uncle, auntie, granddaddy, all of them sing, play instruments, and yeah, bro, that was pretty much it, man. Yeah.
That's live, man. So, you know,
we
got you into beats.
Oh, man, 13. Man, I got tired of beating on the damn table in the lunchroom, bro. Busting my knuckles.
Yeah.
And, I tried rapping, you know, freestyling, but that just really wasn't it for me. So I was just always the go-to guy to make the beats and put the beats on the table. And then my partner, he from Mississippi, named Buggy, he brought down the FL studio at when I was 13, bro.
And I know the main beats people used to mimic was like the Clips grinding beat.
That was my go-to.
Yeah.
That was my go-to
That's
beat.
Right. Yeah. Everybody knows how to make that beat.
Yeah. If you didn't know how to do that, it was like, nah, we don't need you to beat on the table.
Yeah, yeah.
So that was the go-to beat.
Okay, okay. When was it when you like took it serious?
When I finally heard people rapping to it.
Okay, who was the first artist?
Mr. Streets, 45 South Records. They from Ferris.
Okay.
And they was the first guys that really give me a shot. And you know, Ferris pretty small, close-knit town too, but 45 South, Mr. Street 3, the white boy 240, shout out to him. Man, they all really gave me a shot, man. And yeah, when I heard them rapping on, I was like, ooh, yeah. I can make a living off of this.
Yeah,
yeah, for sure. So
that's dope. So the artist, like, I got tuned into your beats was Lil B, you know what I'm saying? So like, how y'all link up with each other? Y'all did like a whole project with each other.
Man, we did multiple projects. We did probably like three to five, honestly. I linked up with him through DJ Deuce. You know, he was with DJ Deuce at the time. And I had told Deuce I'm a producer, and I told him I was gonna send him some beats. And then around this time, Lil B hit me up on my inbox on Facebook and was just like, hey, send me some. Yeah. And a whole lot of ass came out of that. Yes, sir. So ever since then, bro, we just have been rocking. And
yeah.
That's still my brother to this day.
That's what's up. Man. Yeah. And y'all still working some more?
Yeah, we got, I'm on his new album that's gonna come out. I did the intro.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's dope, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to Lil B, man.
Yeah, Lil B, man. Stay down, Lil B.
Yes, sir. So I want to get into the song Headlock.
Oh, man.
Like global right now, you know?
Yeah.
So how you and Yella link up with each other?
God chunked them my way. He sent them my way, man. Because funny story is, we were just talking about Lil B. Lil B had sent Yella my way 6 years ago and wanted me to send him some beats. So I had communicated with Yella a long time ago. Sent them beats 6 years ago, didn't hear nothing back, but last year he had dropped Back In Beezy, and I got the record Slow Motion on there, and it just went from there. DM, he told me to send him some beats, and I sent him like 200 beats. Yeah, way after that. Yeah, so he was just up there, so it was amazing. Like, because I was about to quit, I was about to stop making beats until he hit me up, and that was like God was saying, you better not stop. I got something for you.
Why you so feeling that way?
Struggs had passed, and it wasn't really no other artist that I was working with like that at the time. So when Struggs passed, it was a rough little patch for me. So after he had passed probably like a year or so, I wasn't hearing nothing from nobody. I was sending beats. I was getting denied by big artists, big A&Rs, you know what I'm saying? And I had told my girl at the time, I was like, I'm about to stop.
Yeah. And this is after, I think I was watching Real Life, and you told me, you was talking about you went to like a beat convention or something.
Mm-hmm.
Was that after that?
Yeah. Damn. I went to Atlanta, and they had the like a beat summit, producer grind. And they was picking like the top three producers, and I had made it. So when you get in there, you play your beats for top-notch producers and artists. So Sunny Digital, Chop Squad DJ, and a slew of other producers that's from the A. They got a name for themselves. So, you know, first two dudes go in front of me, bro. It got that typical Atlanta sound that everybody rocking with, and mine is like just real homegrown Texas.
Yeah.
And you can hear it. And they were just looking at me like, yeah, you cool, but you know, we don't wanna work with you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So they crushed me on the flight home. So I get back to the job and I'm like,
did you have any music like some big music at this time or?
At that time it was just Struggz.
Okay.
The record with Ross that we had, the Do It record.
I'm surprised they didn't do no videos for this.
That would have sent it through the roof.
Yeah, that
would have
went up for him.
Yeah. I wish they would have did it too, but that was really mainly it, man. And I flew back home and I was done for. I was like, man, this is, I ain't finna do music no more.
How your reaction was with Yella Beezy?
Bro, it was tears of joy, literally.
Yeah.
In the bed, two or three in the morning, tears of joy. And just being able to be prepared for that.
Having
the beats ready.
Yeah.
Because wasn't nobody purchasing no beats at that time.
Right.
Wasn't nobody inquiring about no beats. They were just sitting there.
Right.
So when he hit me up, I just flooded his email, bro, and the rest is history.
That's crazy.
Yep.
So let's get into the record Headlock. You know what I'm saying? What was that session like?
Really, man?
You was in a session with Young Thug and everything.
No, I wasn't there.
Oh, okay.
initially, he had sent me the record back with just him on it.
Uh-huh.
And, bro, I made that beat probably like 5-10 minutes. Sent it to him. Wasn't thinking of it because he had texted me and said he needed some young nigga shit. So me, I'm thinking, all right, pianos, 808s, snares, whatever. Send it to him. 5-10 minutes, sent it to him. Probably like 2-3 weeks later, he sent me just that version with just him on it. Then I see the Instagram clip of him at the meeting on the table dancing to it with L.A. Reid and them. Then boom, Headlock. With Young Thug on it. And Bud and them, like,
his reaction was to it?
L.A. Reidman was telling them to drop. They need going to drop it.
Yeah.
See, but I wasn't a part of all that. I would just continue to make beats and send them to him. So I wasn't thinking nothing of it as it was going to be.
What it did.
I had no idea.
Yeah.
So when it did drop and I seen the Thug was on it, I was like, oh.
Man, and that was the first big song for you?
That was the first big song. We had Keep It In The Streets first, but then Headlock, Headlock just took it through the roof.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
That's what's up, man. Congrats on that.
Man, I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Yeah, let's get into Keep It In The Streets, you know what I'm saying?
Man, them guitars on there, bro.
What vibe? Like before Yella got on there, like, what was your energy like on it? You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man, just chill, just at the crib. Man, I was actually laying down, like posted up, just laying down and playing some guitars, bro. And I was like, boy, this a vibe.
Yeah.
Let me just continue to, and it took probably like 30 to 40 minutes to just really mix it down and have it right. And I sent it to him, and he just capitalized on it, like.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
Yeah, that's on fire.
Yeah, a lot of people hit me up and be like, bro, Keeping The Streets so hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, so. Keeping The Streets was the first record. Headlock, just poured over them blessings. Like, wow. Yeah. Phone calls and people hitting me up, like, oh, this, you know what I'm saying?
So what was the energy like? I seen the picture with you and Young Thug, you know what I'm saying?
Man, that was probably like a couple hours after the video shoot, the Headlock video shoot.
Yeah.
And,
you flew out there, right?
Mm-hmm.
LA?
Yeah, it was in LA.
Yeah.
And just the video shoot was dope. His energy was dope. Thug's energy was dope. And then going to the session, going to Thug's studio, shoot, Beezy was just like looking at me. I'm sitting back in the, you know what I'm saying, just playing my part, because it's like word of advice for upcoming producers. If you finna work with a big artist or you're in the studio with a big artist, it doesn't, you don't need the attention like that. Just wait till they tell you to play your beats. Yeah. Wait your turn, you know what I'm saying? And just so happened, though, I was playing some exclusive records. And then Beezy looked at me, he was like, nigga, play him something. Because it was dead silence. YB and Cordae was in there. Yeah. Yeah, so I played some beats in there for him, and I was playing stuff that I felt like would match his style. But Beezy told me, man, play that shit for him. Like, play him what we be on. Yeah. So I played him a couple, and that nigga looked back at me like, playing the game. He looked back, had his engineer to the left of him, playing the game. He stopped the game, and he laid down two songs that night.
Damn, you got another record with him,
man. Yeah, man.
Right,
yeah, so.
That's what's up.
Yeah, so.
So, like, tell me about the PMG deal, you know what I'm saying? How did it go?
Oh, it's a production deal. Yeah, it's really self-explanatory, you know what I'm saying? Production deal, working close-knit with the label, Yella, Bodega that you just had on. Yeah, and a slew of the artists that they have there, and pretty
man,
much.
Nah, son,
Bodega.
Your style, man, is crazy, man. Like, it's different. Every song is different.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I salute you on that.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Yeah. Man, them guys is crazy dope.
Yeah.
All of them. Just from Yella to Bodega to Monstah, like all them. They
you
dope.
Some
yeah. I did a collab with OG Lincoln. Okay. On the record for him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that should be coming out soon. So yeah, man, it's been fun. It's been a good ride so far.
Man, so who's some artists you want to work with in the future?
In the future?
Some top artists.
Top
artists. Like, who's some people you want to work with?
Man, I really want to work with Rod Wave. Okay. Kevin Gates. My like ultimate like would be like Bun B.
Okay.
For sure. Just to get just like the style from where I'm from to where he at, just the meshing of the countryness of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like just getting him on that, getting him on the record. Drake, of course, the baby. Man, really just anybody who's doing real dope music, but in a pop realm, like I said before, Justin Bieber, Taylor Swift.
Yeah.
I want to do soundtracks for movies. I feel like I can.
Okay.
I have been doing it. You know, a lot of producers have beats low key that they don't let nobody hear.
Yeah.
So they have their little stash, like, this will be for the right time at the right moment. You know what I mean? But I do have pop. Okay. I do have R&B, gospel, whatever.
Man, so who your top producers, like, you know, you into?
DJ Toon.
You inspired by?
Yeah, DJ Toon. Manny Fresh.
Okay.
Neptune. Corey Moe, Pimp C. Yeah, a lot of people didn't know Pimp C because it was
stupid. I didn't know him.
Yeah. Pimp C called. You're, what was it? Underground Kings.
The Flex Code.
Underground Kings, majority of all the albums you produced. And Jazzy Faye, Zaytoven, of course.
Man, I was about to say, like, Zaytoven, for real, those two, 808 Mafia.
Yeah.
I like my top
favorite producers.
Yeah. Especially for real.
Man. Timbaland, just that whole VA sound. And it wasn't even just a sound, it was just sonically different from everybody else's. And you can just pinpoint, like, that's not Dre, that's not whoever, that's Timbaland, that's either for real, that's Missy, that's all of them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, yeah, man. I got a slew of top, but for sure, Pimp C is in my top five.
Top five.
Top side.
Man, that's fire. That's fire for sure. So let's get into the real conflict. You know what I'm saying?
We're gonna. Yeah.
And how they come together?
Just a simple 10 to 15 minute beat that I had made and sent it to him. And I was in the studio with Gunna at the time. And then he had FaceTime to let me hear the song. But then actually, when we was in LA at the Headlock shoot, he had did the verse to it, but I didn't know.
Yeah.
But the song was fire.
Fire.
Yeah.
Nah, for sure.
And but now it's just like, and the lady loved it.
That's a whole
one. It's just a whole vibe, especially with being cold too.
Right.
Yeah, it's, that's something, the whole vibe, man. Yeah. That record, I love that record. The video, just the whole vibe of the video shoot that day.
Like he walking through a safe and all that.
Yeah, very dope, man. And yeah, bro, that's a good record.
It's a clean record. Make you want to just, you know what I'm saying? Make you want to get spiffy and just, you know, pick up your lady friend and just go.
Yeah,
I like this song. Yeah. Shout out to Yella Beezy. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So, yeah, man, like, where you see yourself, you know, like, a couple years ago, you know, with this music thing, man? Like, you see anything, like, with your music, like, anything lined up with the artists and, you know, that you're working with right now?
Having my own production label.
Okay.
Signing producers and, you know, giving them opportunity that I didn't have coming up. You know what I mean? Really that, man, and just provide an opportunity. I'm a real big one to get it.
Yeah,
so
I was going to ask you, like, you open to work for, like, younger artists? Mm-hmm.
And very open, man, because a lot of people don't give you that shot. They don't hear you. They don't want to hear you. You know what I'm saying? And I remember just being a producer, trying to give away CDs, beat CDs, and niggas throwing them out.
What?
Yeah, bro. I remember, this is... How many years ago? It was probably about 10 years ago when Waka Flocka was in town, man, and they had put on Twitter and put on Facebook that they were looking for beats, bro. Yeah. And I had sent beats to his A&R and his manager, and he told me I should be back. Like, off the first two beats.
But you know, I don't know what, if it's like a season where what they, you know, looking for.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Like, it's crazy.
Yeah, because you know, they took a at that time. Was, and Southside was flooding.
What year was this?
This was like a year, probably like a year after Oh, Let's Do It.
Yeah.
And it was like
2012.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it was, I was trying to grind hard then, and trying to get beats to whoever. I don't care if you were whack, man. I want you on the beats. You got to get out there.
Right.
But yeah, upcoming producers, you know, if you hit me up. Artists hit me up. I'm just down to work with anybody.
That's what's up. Okay. Man, like, any advice to, you know, upcoming producers, you know what I'm saying, to get some game on, you know, how to come up in 2020, you know what I'm saying, production?
Stay consistent with your sound, for one. Stay consistent with the sound, stay consistent with making beats. I mean, you ain't got to do 10 beats. Don't let it fly you and tell you what they do it. 10, 20 beats a day, because that stuff is broken. I'm telling you, just having a creative mind, bro. You have blocks, I have blocks. Every time where I go 2-3 days without making a beat, but you can't let that discourage you. You gotta stay consistent.
You get discouraged? Like, you feel like something ain't sounding right?
Even now, bro, it's just like, I can make a beat, and it may be jamming, like he can make it jamming to you. And in my head, I'm like, that ain't jamming to me.
Yeah.
Like, if you leave me, I'm going to delete it.
Yeah.
I won't even say it.
When it comes to, like, you feel like, I don't want to say trap. It's like, I'm sure you probably master hill.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. Let me ask the question, like, if I know how to put this. I don't know. When it comes to beats, man, like, you feel like trap is more, like, relevant, you know what I mean, as far as, like, getting recognition?
I feel like it used to be. Like, because now, if you hear a lot of records coming out now, a lot of it sounds sad.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, if you listen to, and no shade of, but if you hear, like, a piano, it may have, it's like a sad feeling.
Yeah.
So if you can make those type of beats, those beats are more sought after than trap beats.
Right.
But back then, if you go back 5 years ago, trap beats was like, if you can't do them Southside, no 808 Mafia type, we don't want them. But now it's like, you ain't got no guitars in the song, you know, sad pianos and strings and none of that. A lot of people don't even want to fool with you. But that's what I'm saying. Like, whatever your sound is, stay with your sound, because eventually you're going to find an artist and they're going to bite on it and both of y'all going to take off.
Yeah.
Because I use organs, I use church sounds, bro. And it just so happened it's working, bro. You know what I'm saying? And I just been consistent with that the whole way through.
Yeah. Man, that's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
That's
center, like, and music is like to help. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'll never be our whole people need it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, so man, so you gotta let the people know where they can follow you.
Hey! Instagram, blame it on Monstah. You know what I'm saying? You follow me on Instagram. I don't have a Snapchat or Facebook or Twitter. I'm all Instagram. You can hit me up on there. The beats just DM me. My manager's link is in there too. And be on the lookout for Blank Check. My boy Yella Beezy is gonna be crazy.
All right, man. I appreciate you coming through.
Appreciate you having me.
Yes, sir. All right, you're now talking to FreshTalkz.